Well, last time we analyzed the space station and we found that the space station was unstable. It has a reaction wheel in the middle. So here's the space station. And it's got this, because it's in a gravity gradient equilibrium, but it's unstable. It's good to be near equilibrium, even if it is unstable, because it means you just need a little bit of torque to kind of stabilize it. And in the middle, they have a control moment gyroscope. It's pretty big. It controls for small changes in attitude as people are, walking around or instruments move, or even as the solar panels deploy. Those lead to torques, and you need to adjust for that. So there's a control moment gyroscope. I did want to give you some idea of how they work. The control moment gyroscope, it's a lot like the falling cat. You might go, oh no, what is he launching into now? Here's a falling cat. This is from Smarter Every Day, right? You've seen cats. This is his own cat. He's being nice to the cat, but he's letting go of the cat upside down in slow motion. So the cat starts out with zero angular momentum, right? It starts with zero angular momentum and yet flips around. How can you turn if you have zero angular momentum, if you're a rigid body? Well, a cat isn't a rigid body. The cat's twisting. And here's a creepy simulation of a cat where using that ball and socket joint, right. It starts out zero angular momentum, but as it twists its body, it can achieve an overall reorientation. And you could do the same thing with spacecraft. Here's a creepy side by side of a falling cat. An approximation by two masses connected by a ball and socket joint. So you could start with zero angular momentum and achieve rotation. Here's a spinning wheel. I would have done this in class. You could do the qualitative analysis that we've done. Here's somebody sitting in a swivel chair, and they're going to spin this wheel like crazy. Okay, now what? Let's draw on this what the angular momentum is, at least in one of these directions. About this direction, the angular momentum is zero. So if we were to write this, this is, zero. Initially, for the person sitting in the chair plus the wheel. But there's a large angular momentum. If you have to use the right-hand rule, I think the bicycle wheel was moving such that it has a really large angular momentum. I put L. This shouldn't be L. This is H. Didn't I call it H? Yeah, there. So this H total is zero. But here we've got H for the wheel, and it's pretty large. But because the total angular momentum, at least in the vertical direction, is zero, if he takes that wheel and he twists it one way or the other to maintain total angular momentum zero, he will have to spin. So if he twists this down, h of the wheel, then that means there's this slight downward component. And to compensate, he'll have to have a positive component. So this is h for person, right? So that the total equals zero. H person plus H wheel, at least in that vertical direction. So dotted with Z hat. Can't even see Z hat. This equals zero. So if that's the case, H person is pointing up. And so that means using the right-hand rule, he'll need to turn towards that bowling ball looking thing. So he's going to need to turn like this way. So let's see if that happens in the video. Yeah, there we go. He's turning one way. And then he could actually flip the bicycle wheel over so that the angular momentum of the wheel is pointing up, and then the angular momentum for the person is pointing down, and you have to turn the other way, which is what he does here. And this is essentially how control moment gyroscopes work. Right, the total angular momentum is the sum of the individual angular momenta. And it's weird, like the bicycle wheel is imparting some kind of torque to him to make him move. And so, of course, you could use this effect in space. Here's just a little animation of a spacecraft where that wheel will turn it one way. The spacecraft has to move the other way. And if this was a flywheel that had a very large mass and spins rapidly, but the spacecraft is very large, maybe it doesn't spin as rapidly the opposite way. And then you can control what direction these things go. And this is another simulate. It's like a CAD model. It looks like an experimental setup where they've got a flywheel. And the flywheel initially isn't oriented with the axis of rotation for this thing, which is on like a cushioned table. But then you could get the spacecraft, at least this test bed, rotating one way. You can make it stop. And then if you turn that thing down, then you make it rotate the other way. And this is just an animation, but you could experimentally do this. This was an experimental setup, someone's thesis. But it's on this air hockey table. And they're going to turn on a wheel. And then it stops. So they've turned 45 degrees, and then they'll make it rotate the other way so they can turn back. There we go. Yeah. And then the others are just wheels oriented in other directions so you could get yaw, pitch, and roll. So that's how, in essence, the space station, it has this gyroscope, control moment gyroscope. It's a giant flywheel, very heavy, spins, and through its rigid connection to the space station, it does adjustments, slight adjustments to keep the space station at the attitude that's desired, which is not gravity gradient stabilized, but it is a gravity gradient equilibrium. Yeah, this is kind of interesting. So this paper from 1971, they're like, if you're an astronaut who finds yourself out in space, here's how you do human attitude control. And they have an analysis where they look at, you know, move, they break up the body into these different parts. And they say, like, here's how you achieve an overall pitch. I don't know what these diagrams mean, but they're complicated. Say, here's how you, when you're out in space, you turn things to achieve some motion. You don't need to do this out in space. You could do this if you were to jump off the high dive, right? People do flips and things. And this sphere on the left, they're calling it L, but this is the same as what we've called H, the angular momentum sphere. This is a simulation of somebody kind of diving off the diving board. So they're rotating about one direction, but then they move their arm and they get this additional spin. And depending on how many spins they want to do, and they bring the arm back and then they complete the dive. So when you have multiple rigid bodies, then there's effects. Next time, maybe I'll say something about the docking scene from Interstellar. Right now. All right.